dial in the spray gun to the customer's preferred performance, we have four main points that you can adjust. And I'll work from those top to bottom, starting with the top knob, which is the fan adjustment knob. What that knob does is by dialing it inward, you're concentrating material to the center of the pattern and usually putting more material through the gun. Or dial that out to give yourself a larger fan by dispersing that material into a vertical fan. The next adjustment point, working down on the gun, is the fluid adjustment knob. Think of this as choking off material flow. When you turn that knob in, you're restricting how much material flows through the nozzle. And by turning that out up to a maximum of four turns, you're allowing more material to flow through the nozzle. The next adjustment point is the air pressure on the gun. In order to adjust this, you'll need to pull the trigger just to the point where air is flowing, but no fluid is coming out. At that point, you can read the pressure. The HVLP recommended pressure will be listed on the air cap, but this adjustment allows you to control the texture of your coating. By increasing the pressure, you're decreasing the peel, the resulting peel of the coating, but by decreasing pressure, you're increasing the amount of texture or orange peel in the coating that's applied. The next adjustment point is the actual fluid pressure on the bulk feed system feeding our pressure feed nozzles. By increasing the material pressure, you're going to be increasing the amount of material that's flowing through the gun. That's an adjustment best left to the painter. The final adjustment worth mentioning is that the air cap itself can be rotated, and what this does is allows you to move from a vertical fan pattern to a horizontal fan pattern.